Hello and welcome to another CF PowerScript tutorial with me, Christian Rauchenwald. Now in this video, I'm going to show you how you can add the Snapchat custom events PowerScript to your funnels at ClickFunnels to track, for example, when users start typing in your forms, when they open a pop-up, or when they click on a specific button or link. Now, as always, in order to get started, you will need to log into your CF PowerScript account, and once there, head from the dashboard to your PowerScript section. Now, the Snapchat custom events PowerScript is something that you could theoretically add here globally, but overall, it makes more sense to add it to a funnel specifically, so I'm going to select our development funnel here. And once it's loaded, you can see that I already set up the Snapchat pixel, Snapchat lead tracking, and the Snapchat conversion tracking. And if you want to add those as well, you can just check them out. They all come with their own tutorial video. The only thing you need for the custom event tracking to work is the Snapchat pixel PowerScript. Now, in order to set up the custom event tracking, what you'll have to do is click on Add New, look for Snapchat, select the Snapchat custom events PowerScript, and here you'll see that we have two settings that we have to fill in. First of all, we have to decide if we want to track when a user opens a pop-up. This does not fire when the user leaves the page and it's an exit intent pop-up, but it only triggers when the user clicks on a link to open a pop-up. So you could say, for example, because you have your order form in a pop-up, you want to fire the initiate checkout event when a user opens a pop-up. And additionally, you can decide if you want to track data input. So as soon as the user starts typing into one of your forms, so maybe they start filling in the email address or the name, if you want to fire an event there, which also could be something like add payment info or any other event that you want to choose for that matter. Now it's important to point out, because we are now adding this script globally to the entire funnel, if you have pop-ups on multiple funnel steps, those settings would apply to all those funnel steps. If you want to prevent tracking or firing of some of those events, or you want to track a different event on your opt-in page for the data input than you want to do on your order form, you'll simply have to add the same custom events PowerScript to the specific funnel step as well with the desired settings. Now, last but not least, we also see that we can manually track events. For that, we'll need to copy this part here, and we can click on Add Script. Now, in order to manually track events, you'll need to open your ClickFunnels account and there head to your funnels and obviously select the same funnel where you want to track button or link clicks and simply open a funnel step, like for example, this opt-in page here. Now here, in order to fire a custom event, all you have to do is, for example, click on a button and go to the Get CSS Info section, and here add the text that we copied previously, so CFPS minus SC minus track minus, and add the event name. Now you can find a list of all available event names in the Business Help Center at Snapchat. Once you scroll down there a little bit, you will find an image that lists all the available event names. And it's important to know that you can only track the events that are listed here and that you need to write them exactly the way that they are shown here, case sensitive. So for example, if we would want to fire the add click event when a user clicks on the button, we would change the title here to CFPS minus SC minus track minus add underscore click and click on update. Now, once we save that, every time a user clicks on that button on the live funnel, it will track or trigger the add click event and the Snapchat pixel will record that. In addition to that, the same thing also works for your text link. So if I turn this, for example, here in a link, and I'm not going to link it anywhere, I just want to set it up, then all we have to do is take the text element, go to settings, and again, get CSS info, and here do the same thing, CFPS minus SC minus track minus, and then simply pick one of the available events, like for example, subscribe, and add that at the end, so subscribe. Now, once we click on update here and we save the changes to our funnel step, every time a user clicks either on the button to opt in or they click on the text link that we just created, it would fire the specified event in Snapchat and record it and help you to keep track of how your campaigns perform, what users are doing on your funnels. That's it. That's how easy you can set up Snapchat custom event tracking in your funnels at ClickFunnels, thanks to CF PowerScripts. Now, as always, thanks for watching this tutorial, and even more so, thanks for using CF PowerScripts. See you in one of our other videos. Till then, bye-bye.